Brenda Hollingsworth from OJ Hollingsworth for Ask the Expert. I want to get right to phone calls, Brenda. Barry is on the line, and Barry, I'd love to get right to your question.
Okay, I'd like to know how long it is for the file a civil suit after an accident.
Okay.
Yeah, so normally in Ontario, it's 2 years from the date of the accident or the date that you reasonably knew you were injured. It can be longer for children. There can be shorter notice periods. So if you've had an accident, you're considering a suit, call and get a free consultation from a lawyer. They'll tell you the deadline that applies in your case.
I hope that helps, Barry. Thank you. We'll head to Mike now, who is also on the line. Good morning, Mike. What's your question?
What would you do in the situation where you're having to be a pedestrian and you're crossing within the pedestrian lines with the gentleman with the pedestrian symbol on your side, and the crossing light, the traffic light is red, and the speeding vehicle is coming through the red light and hits you, and you end up landing on the sidewalk, and this vehicle keeps going right through.
Yeah.
That's a hit and run?
Yeah, a hit and run case. So if you have no knowledge of what car it is that hits you, most of us who have car insurance have unidentified motorist insurance. It's actually part of everybody's insurance policy. So if you have an auto policy, you would actually sue your own policy.
It sounds
confusing, but that's how it would work. You would definitely want to have legal advice on that, and you would definitely want to do it promptly because there are some hoops you have to go through. So it's possible. It doesn't mean you can't pursue it, but you need to get on it. So free consultation would be the answer for that one, for sure.
All right. Thank you, Mike. Let's head to Ian now. Ian, what is your question?
Okay. Two things. With the bicycle lanes, does that exonerate the bicycles from the Highway Traffic Act? From my understanding, they used to be covered under the Highway Traffic Act when they were using the roadways, like with the cars.
Do the cyclists have to follow the Highway Traffic Act, I think is his question.
Yeah, I mean, if you're on the roadway,
you're a vehicle.
You're a vehicle. So sometimes a bike lane is on the road, then you're a vehicle. If it's a bike path like the NCC bike path, they have their own set of rules that apply. Usually there's a sign that says speed limit, that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Staying on the right side of the road would apply.
Thank you, Ian. I do want to talk about a couple of those situations there, especially the pedestrian one. Sometimes our instinct isn't to call a lawyer, but you know what? Get some information there.
Yeah, I mean, really, truly, people don't believe that no obligation free consultations are actually that, but they actually are. At our firm and at every personal injury firm virtually in Ottawa, check first, but we all offer free consultations as a public service because we know that it's confusing, that it's hard to get answers. The answers that you're being given are from insurance companies who have an interest in the outcome.
Mm-hmm.
So we all do that. And our firm, we book 7, 8, 9 free consultations a week. So, and even if you don't come into the office, we answer questions on the phone.
There you go.
So you should really take advantage of that.
All right, Brenda Hollingsworth from OJ Hollingsworth. You know, we talk about small things here because of restriction of time. It's obvious that the expertise goes deep, so you might want to make that call, and here's how you can do that. 613-233-4LAW. Email info@ottawalawfirm.ca, askbrenda.ca, and check them out with their newly revamped Facebook.